So now Jim was in such a state that he didn't know what was actually going around him because he's back home tired. So he comes out of his state where he didn't know what was happening. And now he enfolded his Della for 10 seconds, let us regard with discreet scrutiny some inconsequential object in the other direction. Now they embraced each other, wishing Merry Christmas. $8 a week or a million year. What is the difference? A mathematician or a wit would give you the wrong answer. The Maggie brought valuable gifts, but that was not among them. This dark assertion will be illuminated later on. So here, Jim is trying to explain Della that $8 or a week or a million a year, what is the difference? He's telling you pay $8 in a week or in a year. What is the difference? If you go and ask for the mathematician, he's also going to give you a wrong answer. So here he's telling that he's talking about Maggie. What do you understand by Maggie? Maggie are group of three men who went to give gifts at the time of birth of Jesus Christ. Understanding? Yes, so he's telling about this thing to Della. Jim drew a package from his overcoat pocket and threw it upon the table. So now he's brought something. He takes it up and throws on the table. Don't make any mistake, Del, he said, about me. Now he's telling Della, don't do any kind of mistakes and about me. So he's trying to tell, why did you cut your hair only for my sake? I don't think there's anything in the way of a haircut or a shave or a shampoo that could make me like my girl any less. But if you'll unwrap that package, you may see why you had me going a while at first. So now he's telling, if you would have observed me walking out of the house before you, you wouldn't have done this. You open the gift what I brought for you and then you'll realize it. So what can that gift? So now Jim is trying to tell Della that he's angry with what she's done because the gift what he's brought for Della is related to Della for the act what she's done. So let's read and find out what it is. White fingers and nimble tore at the string and paper. So Della starts unwrapping the gift and then an ecstatic scream of joy. She's happy now. And then, alas, a quick feminine change to hysterical tears and wails, necessitating the immediate employment of all the comforting powers of the Lord of Flat. The moment she unwraps the gift, she's happy as well as she's sad. And she starts crying. For there lay the combs, the set of combs, side and back, that Della had worshipped for long in a Broadway window. Beautiful combs, pure tortoise shell with jeweled rims, just the shade to wear in the beautiful vanished hair. They were expensive combs, she knew, and her heart had simply craved and yearned over them without the least hope of possession. And now they were hers, but the tresses that should have adorned the coveted adornments were gone. So now when she unwrapped, she finds that there were combs, and such combs which she was praying for, because she couldn't buy that. And now when her husband has presented, she has no hair to use those combs to set her hair. So now she's realizing what she's done. But she hugged them to her bosom, and at length she was able to look up with dim eyes and a smile and say, my hair grows so fast, Jim. So now she's happy with the combs, and she's sad, upset with this act what she's done. And with her eyes dull, she's looking at her husband and telling, she's trying to comfort herself and convince herself, telling that my hair will grow fast and then surely I can use them to comb my hair. And then Della leaped up like a little singed cat and cried, oh. Jim had not yet seen his beautiful present. So now we just got to know about what Jim had brought for Della. But Della, And Jim doesn't know what Della has brought for him. So let's see, what is this? She held it out to him eagerly upon her open palm. The dull, precious metal seemed to flash with a reflection of her bright and ardent spirit. So now, remember, she had brought a platinum chain for her husband's watch? Yes. Now she's giving it to Jim. See what Jim says. Isn't it a dandy, Jim? I hunted all over town to find it. You'll have to look at the time 100 times a day now. Give me your watch. I want to see how it looks on. So now she's telling, doesn't this chain look good? It doesn't look too splendid? Now you don't have to worry. You can look at look at the time in your watch 100 times. That's going to be so good. And now she's asking for Jim's watch. Give me your watch. I'll help you with it. So see what Jim says. Instead of obeying, Jim tumbled down on the couch and put his hand under the back of his head and smiled. So now instead of obeying Della, telling, okay, fine, take this watch, what he did? He went and he was laying on this couch, that is the sofa, by keeping his hand under his head. Because there is something, he doesn't want to tell it to Della. Del, said he, let's put our Christmas presents away and keep them a while. So now he doesn't want Della to feel bad. So what he's telling, Della, let's keep these gifts away for some time. They're too nice to use just at present. I sold the watch to get the money to buy your combs. And now suppose you put the chops on. So he's telling, Della, I had to sell my watch to buy these combs for you. Don't worry, now just serve the dinner for me. Isn't it sad? They both have sacrificed so much for each other. She sacrificed her hair and he sacrificed his watch. It's really good to know that being poor and young, they had such a spirit of sacrificing such precious gifts. Natural gifts those are. Her hair was a natural gift, and the watch what he was wearing belonged to his grandfather. Right? So the sacrifice speaks a lot. The Magi, as you know, were wise men. Wonderfully wise men who brought gifts to the babe in the manger. They invented the art of giving Christmas presents. Being wise, their gifts were no doubt wise ones, possibly bearing the privilege of exchange in case of duplication. And here, I have lamely related to you the uneventful chronicle of two foolish children in a flat who most unwisely sacrificed for each other the greatest treasures of their house. But in a last word to the wise of these days, let it be said that of all who give gifts, these two were the wisest. Of all who give and receive gifts, such as they are wisest. Everywhere, they are wisest. They are the Magi. So now he's trying to tell Della that the Magi are men who went and gave gift to the gift at the birth of Jesus Christ in the manger. So these men were also very wise, and the gifts what they gave also were wise too. So he's telling that I can just relate the story, I can just tell the event what we, the action and the activity what we did till now is like two small children in a flat who sacrifice their treasures to just make each other happy by exchanging the gifts. So we are the wisest and we are the Magi now. So this is what the title is, The Gift of Magi. Understood, children? Yes. Go through the lesson and learn the meanings given on page 37, 38, 39 and page 40. Thank you.